in 2020, I was working on a pixel dither shader that just started to go downhill, so I scrapped it, but I think it's really cool, so I want to do a breakdown of what exactly this project was before it just all caught on fire. So pixel dithering is this gradient technique that uses the extremes of the gradient and places them in unique patterns so that from far away, it kind of creates the illusion of a third color. And if you look at pixel dither effects, you'll see a ton of stylized aesthetics that I wanted to recreate. The basic idea was to grab an image and attempt to pixelate it by using a mosaic effect. After that, we would somehow make it 2-bit by messing around with random effects. As you can see from these early results, most of what I'm doing is just trial and error. So the black and white effect wasn't working. I tried like a color ramp, that wasn't working either. Eventually I found this really weird effect that I have no idea what it actually is supposed to do. But it worked for this specific problem. And so what it does is that it takes your image and then it splits it up into how many colors you want. So each bit would be assigned a different pattern or color, which would allow me to create maybe a Game Boy aesthetic or a grayscaled pixel art look. You get the idea. All of this would be manually created in a new After Effects composition. I had to create that pattern and variation of that pattern so then I could attach it to a null object. And with a little bit of After Effects code, let's not talk about it, you're then able to program a way for you to toggle the variations of those patterns and the variation of the colors. I like being able to do that now, even if in 2020 I could tell that I was struggling since this file is named Spaghetti, followed by yet another file that's also named Spaghetti, but just in caps. Every new pattern and color scheme would all have to be made in a new After Effects composition and then have to be connected to this toggleable system, which over time I can imagine would just become a huge mess and also very time consuming, which is likely why I later scrapped the project entirely. I've seen a few tutorials where people do something kind of similar to this, but they use a texture to create the effect. And there are even some After Effects plugins which would automate almost all of this work for you. But that kind of goes against the spirit of literally everything I do here. I've used it a lot in backgrounds because they could just spice up a little bit of footage, but it's not that well designed. I want to remake it eventually in like Blender or Unity where I have a lot more control over it than I do in After Effects. Maybe. I don't know yet.